Okay, assalamu alaikum. This is a case where we have a partial denture. The partial denture here was taken, we've taken a primary impression for it. Okay. The primary impression, we had many problems with it, and I recommended in the previous video that we do a special tray. The technician didn't have enough time, and the patient is in a hurry, so we don't have time to do a special tray in the next visit. The patient is in a hurry, so we're going to do a secondary impression here in the leg. Now, what? First of all, why do we need a secondary impression? Because we said we have a drag here on the buccal surface, a drag here, we have bubbles, we don't know if this was recorded correctly, this is the tuberosity. We need it a lot because we're going to do indirect retention from here. Here we're going to do the indirect retention using clasp, but here I'm going to utilize any undercuts I could get around the tuberosity and the hamular notch and a good post dam. Okay, all of these many reasons, we need a special tray. We need a more accurate impression because we're going to depend on the soft tissue very much. I want to create a smooth surface here. I need a post dam. So all of this, I'm demanding a special tray. But because we cannot do a special tray, can I make with this tray a special tray for this? The answer is yes. How do I do that? I modify this tray in a way that it's more accurate around the sulci that I want to create. I want to create good sulci here, and I want to record this ridge very well in a compressed status because we know that this is the area of tissue compression, and this is an area of tissue compression. So I need to take these in compressed status. I want to record the sulcus correctly. I want to border mold around this, okay? So how can I do that by this tray? By using different material. So I'm not going to take all of alginate. I'm going to let you add here a bit of compound. You're going to squeeze it into place. It will do the compression. You're going to border mold it around the sulcus correctly. Okay? A piece of compound only here. Okay? In the saddle area.
Here and here?
Yes, in between these two teeth. You're going to add compound. You're going to press it in place. Then border mold over it. Okay? So you've taken the anterior ridge compressed and you've taken the sulcus correctly.
For the molding building
the same brown material, the compound.
It's a compound.
Ah, you can add to it. You can add a green stick to it if you like more flowable material. So the compound will act for the compression and the border molding will do my border molding that I need in this area. Now in this area, same thing. In the saddle area here, opposite to this saddle area, I'm going to place a piece of compound. Same thing. I'm going to compress it. Now the tray now has one piece of compound and one piece of compound. This is empty still. This piece of compound, I'm going to compress the bridge, and then here I'm going to do my border molding. If I need a bit more border molding, I could add green stick over the compound. Now, once this is compressed and this sulcus is border molded, I have these enough for me, my purpose. This is my purpose. I need to take the soft tissue correctly because I'm going to replace them using acrylic. Now, over this, all of this, I'll place a spray, adhesive spray, and once it dry out, I take an impression, alginate, regular alginate. What will happen for the alginate? When it comes here in this area where the compound is, it will wash away. It will wash away. It will be thin and washed away. So what does the alginate record? It will record these areas, the teeth, the undercuts, the remaining soft tissue, the soft tissue around here where I'm going to do my post-dam. So do I need a special tray now? No, I could use it with two material. So I turn this tray into a special tray. So compound here in this saddle area, border mold it and compress. Another piece here, a second piece, another step. Second piece here, border mold, compress here and border mold here. Once you're finalized, spray adhesive spray and put over all of it alginate and take another impression. So it's a two-step impression with two material. Okay? So this will compensate using a special tray. You don't need a special tray in this case. Thank you.